Hello, I am SquidofLove. Welcome back. Dual Universe was one of the biggest surprises of this year's E3, and since its announcement, the developers, NovaCork, the company that is developing Dual Universe, are trying to explain how some of its features will work and in general how they want to make this very ambitious project a reality. We also have to mention, like we have mentioned in a previous video, that Dual Universe is heavily inspired from EVE Online, something that I find very good, because I always thought EVE Online had some very interesting aspects, some great features that if used properly could create a great game. NovaCork has indeed shared some more info about the most interesting features, the features that will make this game Dual Universe unique, and let's go ahead and talk about this, let's share our thoughts and discuss about them. Dual Universe is a sci-fi first-person MMORPG which is set in a continuous persistent single-shot universe, and this is exactly what will make this game unique. NovaCork has developed a new technology that, like they say, will allow even up to 1 million players to be at the same world playing together at the same time. This sounds absolutely fantastic, but how exactly does it work? What exactly is a continuous persistent single-shot universe? Continuous, first of all, means that you will be able to move from one planet to another. You will be able to go from planet to space and back again to another planet without any loading screens. The movement will be seamless, and this is amazing. This is exactly what we want as players, to move freely without any real problem. Persistent means that the world will develop, the universe of Dual Universe will continue developing depending on what the players are doing, depending on the actions of the population of the server. The environment around players will continue evolving depending on their activities, depending on what they are building, what they are doing. The single shard universe is where the heart of Dual Universe is lying though. The game will use a technology called dynamic space splitting. How does this work exactly? Imagine an area belonging to a certain server, and players inside this area, inside this server, are doing their own thing, they are performing certain activities, they are building, they are going about their business. As more people enter this area, it will become overcrowded, and this will force the server to split into smaller servers. These servers will continue communicating one with each other, so the players that are in the initial area now will belong in different smaller servers, but they will be able to interact with each other because the servers will communicate with each other. As more players enter these areas, the servers will continue splitting, will continue shrinking into smaller, more servers that will continue communicating with each other, making it possible for more players to be at the same place at the same time and communicating with each other, playing together. The server will start shrinking and will continue shrinking into more and more servers in order to handle all this load and making it possible for a lot of players to interact with each other, play at the same place at the same time. And this is how this technology is going to work. The servers communicate with each other, sharing updates of what is going on inside them. But if you start moving away from an area, away from certain servers that were closer to you before, you will not be updated as frequently as before. You will not have a clear view of what is happening in a certain server if you move away from it. You will have a picture of the past, we can say in general. You will know that someone is there, you will know that something is going on in that server, but you will not have a clear view of what is going on and what is happening. You may know that a group of players were in that area doing something specific some time ago, but by the time you return close to that server, they might have left, they might have gone to another area doing something else, or they have changed their activity. It is a very nice technology that will allow you to have a general idea of what is happening in the world around you, a bit far from your location, but it will not give you a clear view of these activities. You will have to get closer in order to investigate and find what exactly is going on. It seems to be a very ambitious technology that will hopefully allow a lot of players to play together, communicate with each other, and try to shape this universe, try to shape this great game, Dual Universe. Now, let's go ahead and talk about combat and what the developers have said about this part of the game. They have mentioned that they don't want Dual Universe to be an FPS. They want instead to use a lock system based on skills. Pretty much how EVE Online combat works. But this is going to be quite different. And I'm saying this because from what we have seen from the teaser, we are building our ships. We have absolute control of our ships. We are flying them. In EVE Online, instead, you are commanding. You're kind of an observer that commands your ship to go to a certain area to do something specific. You are not piloting your ship. So I don't know how this combination of manually flying a vessel and using your weapons with a lock-based system to attack your targets will work. It is definitely a system that we have to see before we judge. It could be a very good combination. Maybe by having a lock-based system on our weapons will allow us to focus more on our piloting, will allow us to focus more on maneuvering around our targets while our weaponry is doing all the job. Of course, the skills and this system will have to be developed perfectly in order to work well and give a very good feeling of combat. Something else that worries me is how this lock-based system will work in foot combat, because we will have a character, we will be able to walk around, to travel, to explore with our character. What happens if we have to fight someone with our character, not inside the vessel, not inside a vehicle, not inside a ship in general? Will then the game turn into an FPS, or we will have again to deal with a lock-based system? I really can't think of a lock-based system working well in foot combat, in characters fighting each other with hand weapons. But again, we will have to see how it will work. We will have to see it in action before we can judge it. The developers haven't said anything about this kind of combat. They have only mentioned, from what I have heard, about spaceship combat and lock-based system. It is also obvious that the developers are not focusing yet on the combat part of the game. And I'm saying it is obvious because they want to develop first the heart of the game, which is the building system, the crafting system. There will be no predefined sets of anything in Dual Universe. Instead, the players will start making their own creations, and if they are good, they can sell them. They can become popular because of these creations. How building is going to work is very easy. You can gather resources and then start making your creation. Let's take a ship, for example. If you create your ship, you can test it, and if it is good, if you are happy with its performance, you can create a blueprint out of it. You can use later this blueprint in factories, where you can make copies of that ship and keep them for yourself or sell them to make some profit. You can even sell the blueprint itself in order to make profit. Again, we can see how Dual Universe is very similar with EVE Online, research and manufacturing features. Like I said, if your creation, if the ship you have created is good, it will sell well, it will give you money, but it will also give you a reputation as a good ship designer. The more good designs you put in the market, the more profit you make, and the better your reputation will become. So you will be eventually able to even conquer the market, become a very famous ship designer. And this is also part of what the developers want to create in Dual Universe. They want to give players the opportunity to make great creations, sell them in the market, and make a name for themselves. It seems that Dual Universe is going to be a very good game for anyone that loves building, for anyone that loves crafting. Another very interesting feature of Dual Universe, of course, is going to be exploration. With procedurally generated planets, it will be possible to spend most of your time exploring. There will be so many systems, so many planets for you to explore, that the only limitation is going to be your time. And I'm saying your time because you'll have to travel in a system in real time in order to land on a planet and start exploring. It will be quite time consuming if you don't have the proper technology. You will have to research and unlock technologies that will allow you to go faster, further, and explore more systems and planets. It will be even possible to build drones and send them very far away in space, so far away that it could take them months, real months, in order to reach the destination, deploy a certain device that will allow you to transport yourself over there and start building a Stargate that will give the opportunity to go back and forth. Again, we have to see exploration, we have to see how this activity will work in order to know what we are getting exactly, but it sounds very interesting. It reminds me a lot of what No Man's Sky is trying to do with the procedurally generated planets, and I'm really excited for this activity. It seems to me that Dual Universe has some very interesting features, and if NovaQuark managed to develop the game the way they are describing now, we're gonna have a great and unique game on our hands when it will be released, when it will be out there. Now, when will this happen? When we should expect to have Dual Universe on our hands? Initially, they were talking about a closed alpha during this year, 2016, but the time frame has been pushed back a bit. We should be able to get a closed alpha at the beginning of 2017, and we are gonna get a beta 1 year after, around 2018. So we still have a long way ahead of us. We will have to have patience waiting this amazing game. Something else I want to talk about is the pay model that the developers are considering for this great game. So far it seems that they are preferring a pay to play game and monthly subscription, so you will have to pay money monthly in order to have access to their content. And although I understand that a monthly subscription is great for funding the game, for keeping the game running, and of course giving to the developers the opportunity to work on updates, I can say I agree with the pay to play model. I think it's outdated and it doesn't belong to this era of gaming. I would prefer to have a buy to play model where you can buy the game once and gain access to it, and maybe offer an option subscription to players that want to support further the game. And trust me, many players will support the game. And even combining these two options with a cosmetics only shop, the game has a lot of possibilities. Players will build their own home, players will build buildings. There are a ton of cosmetic items that you could put in a cosmetic shops only, and players will take advantage of this in order to make their buildings look better, look more beautiful, but also support the development. Anyway, these were my thoughts on Dual Universe and the development process. These were my thoughts on what the developers NovaCore has revealed so far. I'm pretty sure that as time passes, we will get to know more about the game. We will know more info about how this universe is gonna develop, is gonna come to life. What do you think of the game so far? What do you think of these activities? What do you think of what NovaCore has revealed and shared with us already? I would love to hear your thoughts, especially on combat exploration and the building system of the game. I would love to hear everything you have to say about Dual Universe. Thank you for joining me. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to subscribe for more. I am SquidofLove, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.